Hey, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video. And as you can see, this time I want to dry my hands again on an image of the Castle Neuschwanstein in southern Germany. I have tried to get a good edit of similar images, but until now I wasn't 100% satisfied, so I want to give it another try with this one. And for this photo, I'd like to only use Adobe Lightroom for the editing and maybe make use of the Nik Collection plugin later as well. So before I start, let's first take a look at the before and after images. And of course I'm starting in the lens correction tab by activating those two settings. Then let's go back to the top. And right away I want to change the profile to Adobe Standard. And this will just reduce the contrast of the image a little bit, so I just have more control over it myself. Then I'm not changing the white balance since I like the overall color tones of the image, and I want to jump straight into the exposure balancing. And for this shot I actually want to apply heavy contrast and make the whole image rather dark, especially the foreground, so only really the castle itself is visible in there. So let's first just drop the exposure. And then I'm also dropping the highlights. And instead of increasing the shadows, I'm dropping the shadows this time. And quite a lot actually. Let's also drop the blacks. And to not lose too much brightness in this image, I'm increasing the whites. Okay, also I think I want to add some contrast, and then let's also add some clarity. And finally I want to drop the texture a little bit. This will just make everything a little bit smoother. And then let's add some saturation by increasing the vibrance. Okay, good. Now you can already see there is a lot of underexposure going on, but in this case I don't care since most of the underexposure is right there in the foreground and I don't want to have any detail in there. So let's jump into the local adjustments. Here I have created a gradiated filter for the sky part, which I want to change a little bit, but I only want to affect the sky, not the mountain range in the back. That's pretty easily done by using a range mask, and I can click on it and select color. And now with the eyedropper tool I can simply select the color range I want to target. In this case I'm going for the sky obviously. And then I can also adjust the amount of the color range. Now when I'm applying my changes, like dropping the temperature, only the sky will be affected by it. So here I want to have a bluer sky, so I'm dropping the temperature. And let's also drop the exposure just a little bit. Okay, that's it for this area. Now of course I also want to work on the castle in the center of the image, and here I have applied a radial filter. Again, I only want to target the castle, so I'm using the color range mask again. Use the eyedropper tool and pick a color from the castle. And now let's increase the exposure. And that's it for the local adjustments. Then let's do some color grading. I'm starting in the HSL window in the hue tab. Here I want to drop the orange hue slightly. Then let's head over to the saturation tab. And let's increase red saturation to make the mountains in the back look a bit more like they are glowing. And maybe let's drop the blue saturation a little bit. Okay, and in the luminance tab I want to drop the blue luminance a bit, which will just make the sky even darker. Okay, now for the split toning I'm not touching the highlights, I'm instead just applying a coke color tone for the shadows. Something like this looks pretty nice, and then let's sharpen the image. And that's pretty much it, but of course I also want to get rid of this sensor spot right there. Here I'm just using the spot removal tool. And this will fix it. And at this point I want to stop the editing. So I hope this video was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions, then please feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.